Hey, my brother.
Hello.
Ashtar here. Yeah, what an honor. Thank you for taking the time.
Okay.
So, how are you today? Are you feeling okay?
Yeah, everything's okay.
All right. So, my question number one, it's in regards of Comet Lovejoy. It has, something to do with the hiring of consciousness as well as the event.
It's a very strong symbol which actually signifies the return of light. And because it is passing quite close to the constellation of Orion right now, it means that we are now in a period when the transformation of the duality consciousness of the darkness, which originates from Orion, all that transformation is taking place right now.
Okay. Is this also related with the so-called Planet X or, Nibiru?
There is no direct relationship with this comet and Planet X.
Okie dokie. Some of these are some of the questions from our listeners. They are asking, if the reptilians that are still, among us are in the power and or is just the minions, the so-called Illuminati. The extraterrestrial reptilians, like the Anunnakis or the reptilian race, are in control of the Chimera group or Illuminati or whatever, people call it.
So the Chimera group is at the top, and all other groups are actually not having so much influence on the situation in general.
Now, in regards of the false flags, what do you think the inspiration of this latest false flag in Paris, France? What do you think is their aim? What are they planning to implement with this state of, more control? What is your opinion on that?
Basically, the Archons want to create more fear. They want to maintain the vibrational frequency of fear to have people under control. This is the purpose of all the false flags in general, to maintain the vibrational frequency of fear on the planet. And they usually do them on symbolic spots like Paris, New York, London, Madrid, because this creates the most amount of fear, because those places are symbols for humanity, and if those places are not safe, people do not feel safe anywhere. So this is the main reason why those events are happening.
I agree with you. How about, like a chess game? This particular move, what do you think was precisely geographically done in Paris, France? Where do you think they did that?
Paris is an important vortex point. Actually, it is a vortex point for goddess Isis, and is connected directly energetically with the Giza Plateau. It's one of the main vortex points in the planetary network of life. And if something like this happens in Paris, it has quite much of an influence on the whole energy grid. And this is why it happened in Paris.
That makes sense, absolutely. A lot of our listeners are asking, as you may imagine, about the event. And when is this, conflict in some parts of the world, like in the Middle East and Africa and South America? There's a lot of still pain and suffering. People want this suffering to stop, and they're looking forward to receive some sort of help and prosperity funds, etc. I feel personally this is happening soon. When do you feel is happening?
I cannot give you any dates because, first, I would not reveal the plans to the people who are not live for listening to this. And number two, it is a dynamic plan. Things are changing moment by moment depending on what people are doing, depending on the free will of humanity and of everybody involved. So it's not actually possible to say when exactly things will happen. But yes, they will happen, and they will happen relatively soon.
Yeah, hopefully, I agree. So that includes the whole package. We're talking about the RV, which is the currency reset, all the financial reset, this new financial system as well. With all these updates, there's a lot of bloggers talking about the RV happening, this month, you know what I mean? And it was supposed to happen by Christmas, last year. So we agreed after that. That will be like the doors opening for the so-called disclosure and therefore the event, right?
I have outlined the plan for the event many times, and the financial reset is part of the event. It is not the whole event, but one aspect of the event definitely includes the financial reset. And people just waiting for the financial reset are not having the right strategy because, first, we don't know when it's going to happen, and it's not wise to depend your destiny and your financial security on that. It might still take some time. There is no guarantee it will happen, especially this month. So people saying it's happening today or tomorrow are not having a real perspective on how things are. and the state of affairs at this moment. We are not there yet.
Okay. Regards of the financial system, you know, they're saying that it's already in the hands of the light forces, right? Is that it?
The reset and the new financial system will definitely be of the light forces. Now, of course, the other side is also having their own plans, but they will not be successful.
Okie dokie. Yeah, thank you for that. Yeah, now going back to your recent comment about Agartha, our listeners are asking, have you been in Agartha yourself?
Before, I have been into the resistance movement many years ago. That's a long time ago, many, many years ago.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's awesome. And what was your impression? Do you think people will definitely like it to visit such a place?
People will like it when they see it, but they will not see it before their vibrational frequency is high enough. And before they're able to live in peace and harmony between themselves. So they will not be accepted to see those places before a certain healing process happens.
Wonderful. Now, how does that look like? How would you describe Agartha or the place where you were?
Actually, I have seen a few places, and first they have a quite advanced technology, which makes their lives easier. They live underground, and they live in a peaceful and harmonious society. What I have seen was quite advanced computer technology, and also I have seen an underground spaceship. And that spaceship was quite large. It was, I would say, about 150 meters long. I haven't been there for a long time, but I have received about the plan for the event many years ago.
Awesome. Now going back to the IS portal, we were all, praying, meditating very hard, you know, for Egypt and all that. How could you, explain about how the importance of this IS portal that just happened the last month?
This portal actually initialized the breakthrough phase for the planetary liberation, which is very important. And also a certain goddess, a certain cosmic entity, which was coming from another solar system, has entered the planetary surface and is now on the surface of the planet, anchoring the energies and assisting in making this transition as easy as possible. So this is an amazing achievement, which was not possible before.
Wow. I'm glad that the numbers were good, you know, to continue going higher, right?
Yes.
So how would you describe the goddess energy that is pouring, you know, to our planet? How would you describe that?
Okay, goddess energy, it is the energy of love and acceptance. It is the energy which was missing greatly on this planet during the 25,000 years of occupation, and especially it was missing in the last 2,000 years. It is time now to bring that energy back. This energy must return, and it is needed for the planetary liberation, because when there is enough of this goddess energy present, people cannot be controlled anymore. People will put boundaries, people will say no, and the infection which is present on the planet will be removed.
Wonderful. So that's pretty much like the difference between being in the ego than being on the heart, right? The goddess energy, like being in the heart.
Well, some people can describe it in this way. There are many ways to describe it and many ways to experience it. And this energy will definitely transform the planet.
Okie dokie. There's a lot of people also asking, what are the archons and how to be protected from the archons?
Most of the archons are on the etheric and plasma plane. Very few of them are on the physical plane. And you can protect yourself by creating a shield, a mirror shield around you. And I will actually post a certain meditation on my blog, which has been given by my dragon contacts, have suggested to bring a certain a special meditation to people that will allow people to be protected more. Because there is a great need for more protection.
Right. Yeah, that's good that you mentioned that. That's exactly what my next question was going to be. Like, what type of meditation do you recommend besides the Sunday weekly meditation, which is awesome, and I highly recommend everyone to do that every week. I start doing that in Sedona myself with a bunch of other light workers. What meditation do you recommend to do, like, in a daily basis?
And simply connect with the light. Breathe in light, breathe out light. Connect with the light and love energy, whichever works for you. The other thing that you can do is just to focus upon your breath. By focusing on your breath, you can reach an interesting state of consciousness, and actually you can start balancing your energy field, and you will be less vulnerable to those attacks which are happening.
Right. Yeah, thank you for sharing that. Another question is, do you feel closer with what civilization? Do you feel closer with the Pleiadians, the Andromedans? Which civilization are you closer with?
Well, the Pleiadian race is very dear to me because actually this is part of my origin and I have a very deep connection with them.
Yeah, me too. Now, what can you tell us about the so-called Order of Star?
Order of the Star is a group of incarnated 144,000 star beings that came from various star systems many, many thousands of years ago in order to help transform the situation on this planet. And the purpose of the Order of the Star is to transform all darkness and to bring light back to the planet.
Oh, that's awesome. We are definitely a part of it, right?
Yes, many people are part of the Order of the Star without knowing it.
Right. So, another important question people are asking, could you share the importance of the ley line? How important is it for people to meditate and send light to the specific ley lines around the planet?
This is very important because the ley lines are key to the vibrational balance of the planet. And as the other forces are using ley lines to create darkness, so the light workers and light warriors can use ley lines to bring light to the planet and bring healing to the planet and bring inspiration to the people, because the energy of inspiration and love travels through the ley lines and actually can positively affect people who are with various towns and cities and villages along that ley line.
Now, specifically on Egypt, how important is Egypt? You know, I feel a great connection with Egypt myself. How important is Egypt in the Egypt ley line or the portal for the planetary liberation?
Egypt is actually a trigger point. This is where many things have already started and where many things will influence the planetary liberation process. It is actually an anchor point for cosmic energies, the Giza Plateau especially, and that place can transmit energies through the vortex of the Giza Plateau and then through the planetary ley lines all across the planet.
Yeah, I think that's wonderful to know. So now, what's the next window of opportunity that is happening in 2015 for all these wonderful changes to happen?
We are inside the window of opportunity, which will close on March 17th. The event does not need to happen inside of the window of opportunity. It can happen anytime, either inside or outside of the window of opportunity. It is simply that when the window of opportunity happens, we have more chances and more energy support to make the breakthrough.
Thank you for that. Now, yeah, another listener is asking us in regards of all this fear, you know, mongering, specifically, you know, with the diseases and specifically the Ebola or Ebola, you know, how to protect themselves from all this so-called, you know, disease that is spreading around.
You don't even need to protect yourself. Just do not put your attention to all this because most of this is disinformation.
Plain and simple, right?
Yes.
Now, about the, you know, another common question is they're asking us about the crop circles. There's a lot more, there's even crop circles appearing on ice. You know, who is doing it and what are the meaning of all these crop circles?
There are many crop circles that are fake, but there are some crop circles that are real, and many of them are done by the Pleiadians as an awakening tool for humanity. They have encoded messages that can help human beings to awaken to the reality of higher dimensions.
Is that in a specific language or in a specific code, you know, to decipher them?
It is usually a language of light which uses symbols to awake higher aspects of human mind.
Okay, that's awesome. Thank you. People are asking in regards of the coming of our beloved Jesus Christ. Is he coming?
Actually, many beings of light will come when the time is right. They will come on the surface of this planet, including the one that people call Jesus Christ. So there are many beings of light waiting for the right moment to appear, and when it will be safe for humanity to receive them.
Yeah, another question is, you know, people will be able to see their own relatives, like the dead relatives. They went to, you know, to the higher dimensions.
There will be a certain contact established when the time is right, yes.
Okay. There's a lot of things happening in regards to Mars. What can you tell us about Mars?
I would say there is a lot of disinformation, misinformation about Mars. There has been a secret space program done by the breakaway civilization, by the Deep Black projects in US military, but all this has been cleared already. It's not existing anymore, and now there are many representatives of the light forces present on Mars. Their purpose is to assist in the liberation of this planet, of planet Earth, from the Chimera group.
Oh, okay. How about the moon? You know, it's also, we know that there's some bases on the dark side of the moon.
It is exactly the same situation. Yes, there were bases on the moon which belonged to the secret space program. Those bases have been cleared, and now there are many bases of the light forces on the surface of the moon and below the surface of the moon. People belonging to the resistance movement and also Galactic Confederation fleet, and they are preparing for the right moment to assist in the final liberation of planet Earth.
Yes, thank you. Now, in regards of free energy, how is that going to be, you know, implemented and distributed to the people, free energy?
Okay, there are many inventions which are now being suppressed, and when the event happens, this suppression will be lifted and those inventions will be suddenly released to the masses very quickly when the event happens. And at a certain moment after the event, when the first contact happens, all those technologies will be upgraded with their higher cosmic aspect. So we will have a very steep learning curve about the technology on the planet.
Okay, thank you. Now, what is the compression breakthrough?
The compression breakthrough is the moment when the light from below, from the resistance movement, and the light from above, from the galactic light forces, meet in the middle on the surface of the planet, and this will happen at the event.
That's awesome. What can you tell us about the cities of light that are appearing around the world? Cities of light appearing in China, there's here in the U.S., in Sedona, Arizona, there's a city of light appearing there.
Can you show me some evidence of this? Because there is a lot of talk about this on various blogs, but there are no cities of light appearing anywhere on the physical plane. On the etheric plane, yes, there are some changes, but we are not on that in that space yet.
The basic evidence so far is like just from the credible sources. Like, for instance, I personally met the channeler Mike Quincy from UK. He's talking about that. I also lived in Sedona myself and knew this person that wrote a book about it. So there is just from the faith, you know what I mean, from the heart, that I personally feel that there is, you know, some truth about that. It's just like anything else. It's not materializing yet.
Yes, I would say there is light coming in those vortex points, but I wouldn't say the cities of light are appearing yet, because when this will happen, it will be a very dramatic change. Even when they will appear on the etheric plane, it will be a very dramatic change and a very strong energy. Something much stronger than what's happening now. It will be something very obvious and very easy to feel, even if only half on the energy plane. So we're not there yet.
Right, we need to raise our consciousness, right?
Yes.
Yeah, now about the water worlds. What can you tell us about the water worlds and visiting, you know, the water worlds, obviously, after the event? There's a lot of talk about that, about, you know, Venus and Mercury, that they have oceans and that we will be invited to visit all these places. I was just wondering if you have any information about that. My question is, what do you know about Venus, Mars, human beings visiting all these different worlds that will be available after the event?
Yes, after the event, sometime after the first contact, human beings will be able, at a certain point, to visit other planets in the solar system as part of the process of acceptance into the Galactic Confederation. So the first phase will include human beings traveling to other planets in the solar system and also beyond. So yes, this will happen when the time is right.
Again, when the time is right.
Yes.
Yeah, just, you know, going back to NESARA and the Prosperity Funds, what will be the steps to follow for people to receive these funds?
Those funds will be distributed through the existing banking system. People will receive money on their bank accounts after the event. Of course, certain banks will go bankrupt, certain banks will be restructured, but basically, a great part of the distribution network for money will be intact, and this distribution network will receive and send funds from the collateral accounts to humanity.
Right. How about those people that have no bank accounts or don't believe in, you know, having a bank account?
There are other ways to distribute money, but most people in the West especially have a bank account.
Yeah, some people were talking about 800 numbers, that people will be able to call to 800 numbers for free and get all the information.
This will also be part of the distribution network and about information network at the time of the event and shortly after the event. Yeah, this is true.
Now, somebody else is asking us if the so-called HAARP is still, you know, in use against humanity. Is HAARP still in use with weather modification? And
actually, what they're talking about is a scalar network, and it's not just HAARP facilities. There are many facilities around the world. Most of this has been removed, but there is one aspect of this that is quite unpleasant, and it's not just about weather modification. It's about behavior modification and consciousness modification. It's a network which keeps humanity in the vibrational frequency of fear, and it suppresses people so they do not revolt against this control. And when this network is removed, it will be removal of this scalar network, this technology, goes together with the event. So those things are connected.
Oh, wow. Thank you, my brother. This other listener is asking us, why is the gap between the time-space continuum on Earth so much different than the time on the etherical or in the cosmos? Why the continuum is different on Earth?
I would say the perception is different, but because consciousness defines how you perceive time. If your consciousness is more clear, you have much more control over the perception of time.
Yeah, so it's all the perception, yeah? Now, just some of the last questions that we have for you. It's, do you work in person or by channeling, you know, with your forces?
What I'm doing with my mission is not channeling. I have physical sources and I have non-physical sources. And I have different means of communication with them. But I cannot describe exactly how this communication works.
Of course. That's awesome. Do you have any news that you would like to share, your website, any updates that you would like to share with us?
I will make updates on my blog, and you can just check my blog. When the time is right to release more, it will be there.
Can you tell us your website?
Okay, you just go to Google and you can type Cobra Portal, and you will get the first hit is my blog.
Cobra Portal, right. So definitely the victory to the light is near, my brother, huh?
Yeah, the victory of the light is near. It doesn't mean it will happen tomorrow, but we're getting closer and closer. And it is very important for people to unify, do not fight with each other, but unite forces and start cooperating, because together we are stronger.
United we're stronger, yeah. Now, what techniques would you recommend for people to start, you know, doing right now in terms of preparing for the so-called event?
It's not so much about the preparing for the event. Now, what is important for people is to start doing their mission, to follow their higher guidance, and to do whatever they can for the liberation. And this is a very individual question. Each individual needs to find his or her own calling and her own specific way of doing this. So I cannot answer this generally. It is just time for people to start being active and very dynamic in this process. It is not time for waiting, it's time for action.
Agreed. I agree with you.
I would just like to thank you for this invitation, and I would like to thank everybody for listening.
No, absolutely, my brother. Yeah. Thank you so much for taking the time of your busy schedule. And, you know, you can count on Ashtar Sheran Radio to, you know, be a tool of sharing the news, the updates that you have. Thank you so much, my brother. I send you a big hug. I'm so grateful for your time. And we're just an email or in a Skype away, right?
Yes, yes, exactly.
All right, so this show will go on either Saturday, depending how soon, you know, we can make this happen, either for the 17th or for the 24th of January.
Okay, okay.
Okay, my brother, so that's it. Thank you so much.
Okay, very good.
God bless you, Cobra. Thank you, my brother. Appreciate it.
Thank you, bye.
Bye-bye, namaste.